Where am I? Could this be what humans call a dream? Fascinating.
Protect the schism.
What?
If the schism is lost, nothing will stand between the world and Spyrex.
That's right. I must protect Risa Maxia from Spyrex.
You must protect spirit kind and humanity alike. That is your purpose in life.
Exactly. If I die, the world would be in grave danger.
Maxwell cannot die.
That's right.
You must not choose death.
Never.
You must never choose death. When Maxwell dies, when that happens...
That voice. I swear I've heard it before. A long time ago. I wonder what happened after I passed out. Is everyone okay? Anybody? Jude?
Come to give your report? Huh?
Far too easy. Too careless. Self-doubt, hesitation, dreams. It's like I'm becoming human. It's been a while since I've been alone. Back where I started.
Thank goodness. We never thought you would wander off on your own. We were most concerned.
I'm sorry. I was careless. Where are the others?
We don't know.
Huh? What in the world happened? I see.
Who would have thought those people from Azul would come to our rescue?
Indeed.
I am certain the others are safe.
I hope so too.
It's one of those flying ships from the marsh.
What are those things?
Wow, Rowan. I figured someone your age would have seen everything by now.
I assure you that's not the case.
What's wrong?
It's nothing. Let's just look for the others. They must be close.
Right.
Shall we explore the cave?
Why am I feeling this way? Is it because of the dream? You two must have brought me here after I fell into the marsh flow.
Yep, and you're a whole lot heavier than you look.
We put you in the cave to rest while Leia and I split up to search for an exit.
Forgive me. I've been a burden to you.
Hey, come on, don't worry about it. We're all lucky just to have made it off that battlefield alive.
Indeed, we are. In any case, I am glad you are well.
Of course I am. Maxwell can't afford to die.
Hey, do you know where we are? Is this Azul?
I haven't the faintest idea. There is still much in the world that remains a mystery, even to me.
Are Wingle's words still troubling you?
Are you worried no one's around to unify things now that Noctegaal's gone?
You could say that. For all his stubbornness, Noctegaal had a gift for unifying the people.
Roshigal's recent growth is a testament to that.
I dread what will happen to it now. The question of whether I could do anything to help constantly plagues my mind.
I'm sorry. I never realized it all affected you so much.
Quiet.
Huh?
The soldiers from the marsh.
What's so special about Maxwell? She looks just like a regular old broad to me.
I can't believe they want us to capture that witch alive. What a big waste of time. Killing her would sure be easier.
It would appear they are alone.
Maybe we could squeeze some info from them. You know, rough them up and stuff.
Perhaps. But could we really capture them with just the three of us?
Did you hear that? I better go check. All right. Watch yourself.
This is our chance.
Right. We can do this.
Who's there? Hey! What is it?
Piece of cake!
Far too easy. I'm sorry, you two.
No need to apologize.
Yeah. You know we're here for you, right? You can tell us if something's wrong. Doesn't matter what it is, and you might feel better getting it off your chest.
What do we have here? Could this be a Spyrix?
It's a spirit fossil.
Mila, I assume you know something about all this.
I do.
Is it also possible you know where these people come from?
They're from outside Risa Maxia.
What?
What? I don't understand.
This world, Risa Maxia, is surrounded by a spirit art known as the Schism. Outside the Schism lies a world called Olympias.
And these people came from there?
I am certain of it.
Mila, does Jude know about this?
Perhaps I should have explained this all to you sooner.
Be on guard, you two. Something's coming.
What is that? That was close.
We must leave this cavern immediately. We can worry about finding the others once we're out. We'll finish our conversation then.
Very well.
I know Mila said there was a world outside Risa Maxia, but I still can't believe it.
Nor I. And yet I can find no other explanation for the army that suddenly appeared from the sky. Is it possible that those flying vessels were from somewhere within Risa Maxia?
I doubt that.
Then if we have eliminated the impossible, whatever remains, however improbable, must be the truth.
I've heard that from Jude before. Something about an egg. Let's see, one world inside the egg, and one world outside it? Ugh, it's so damn hot in here! All I can think about is the egg frying on one of those rocks!
Indeed. Let us focus on finding a way out of here.
That monster's body was covered in flame!
That was a fire teagle. It's a monster with a very powerful manalobe.
So you're saying it channeled those flames?
It can simultaneously maintain two arts, offensive and defensive, and uses them to wrap itself in flame.
Whoa! That thing's better at spirit arts than I am!
It even uses the flames on its back to cook its prey before it consumes it.
Huh. For a monster, it's quite the chef.
Indeed it is. Maintaining the right level of flame to cook a creature whole is a serious culinary challenge.
Thanks for that lovely image, Rowan. You know it was trying to eat us, right?
Hey, can I ask you two something? Do you think I have what it takes to be a nurse?
Are you asking because of what happened to that soldier? The best nurse in the world couldn't have saved him.
It's not just that. The main reason I want to be a nurse is because I thought it'd be nice to help Jude. You know, as my job.
What's wrong with that?
Are you troubled by what Agria told you back in the capital?
A nurse's job is to help sick people, right? I just worry that my patients would question my motivation if they knew.
Personally, I don't think motives are particularly important.
But what if I start making mistakes? I might start thinking it's the effort that counts. I'd be giving myself excuses for my failures.
Is that the same one from before?
except now it sounds even more ticked off.
The soldiers likely encroached on its territory while they were searching for us.
Where is it coming from?
Mila, behind you!
Right on point!
How could this be?
Calm yourself. Leia, please provide support.
You got it. Let's do this. Stop.
Farewell.
Please provide support.
Right on point. Stop.
Rolling assault.
Stop.
Farewell.
Stop. Ugh. It's like I got fried.
My mustache is singed as well.
I'm sorry. This is my fault.
No, that's not true.
I've been nothing but a burden to you both lately.
It happens to the best of us. Don't let it trouble you.
What is this maddening feeling? I don't know how to describe it, except to say it gets in the way whenever I need to focus.
Are you okay?
So, back to your question from before.
Huh? Right.
Results are always important, yes. But what's even more crucial is the resolve to do what must be done. Even when I lost the four, even when I became crippled, I still had the willpower to complete my task.
Indeed. Without will, success cannot follow.
Yeah, you're right. Hopefully I'll figure it all out. By the way, what do you think about me wanting to work alongside Jude someday?
Don't worry. I won't abandon either of you before you find your answers.
I'm not sure you got the gist of my question, but thanks. Guess I was just imagining things?
All right, let's go. The exit should be ahead.
Yes.
Okay. As if it wasn't hot enough, now we have this!
A river of magma. I've never seen such a thing.
Really? I see them quite frequently. For example, when a freak gets mad at Gnome for oversleeping, and those two go at it, the surrounding area usually ends up being reduced to a pool of lava.
The great spirits of fire and earth fight with each other?
Then Undine will tell them to cool it and flood the area with water, causing a huge explosion.
Surely this happens only rarely.
No, it happens all the time.
Only to you, Mila.
I'm getting the shivers just thinking about it. Where are we?
Look, it's Cambalar's castle.
Mila!
You're okay!
Mila! I missed you!
Am I glad to see you?
I'm so glad you're all safe. It's good to see you again.
I wholeheartedly agree.
Mila?
Oh. Do I know you? I've never seen you before.
Huh?
Why, I am your elder sister.
Sister? I don't have a sister.
What's going on, Muse?
This may be our first time speaking true. Yet we are both spirits born into this world at nearly the same time.
Well, you definitely are a spirit. That much I can believe.
No need to be so suspicious. What could a spirit gain from impersonating your sister? You are Maxwell, after all.
That's true. It wouldn't gain her anything.
Why did you appear before Jude?
Because you summoned me before him, or rather, your powerful feelings for him summoned me. Really? Could that that even be possible?
I don't know. I'll admit, I've been hearing a voice in my dreams.
Wingo?
Hold that thought. So, the information was correct.
Subjugation is not our goal. Such extreme measures were only necessary to prevent an apocalyptic war between two superpowers. You have my word that we at Exodus will do all in our power to preserve your safety and your livelihood. We desire the same thing you do. Eternal peace, or Rhythmaxia.
I despise that man, Gilland. He promotes peace, even as he uses Spyrex to hurt humans and spirit kind alike.
We may have no choice but to eliminate him and his group.
I agree.
How will we do that?
Those people have armored soldiers and flying ships and big cannons and...
Alvin, it's time you came clean. You should tell us everything you know. Alvin!
I assume Gaius won't stand for this.
He is inviting us in. Frankly, I'm surprised he even revealed himself to us.
Maybe they're testing us?
It's not a trap, is it?
What are we waiting for? Let's go.
What happened?
I'm on the straight and narrow now. I promise.
And why would we believe you this time?
I have a score to settle with Gillen. Let me be the one to finish him off. If I betray you again, you have my permission to run me through with that sword of yours. So let me come with you.
And if I refuse?
Then I'll kill him on my own.
Very well.
Thanks. I appreciate it.
We have to find out what Gaius is planning.
Yeah.
I have you to thank for saving Jude.
Not at all. Jude was quite a help to me. Thanks to his direct tethering with me, I was able to recharge much of my lost mana.
Jude, you direct tethered with her?
Yeah. Muse asked me to. Was that bad?
Bad? It's, direct tethering is something a spirit and a human do when,
Since we were together constantly, he was able to fill me with loads of mana.
I had no idea you were that kind of man.
Mila, wait! Why is she so angry?
My, I can't believe you'd ask me to explain that to you. Do you just want to hear me say it? Is that what you're into?
Someone tell me what is going on with these spirits.
That last battle was a little too close.
Agreed. If Jude hadn't been there to save us, it would not have ended well. You have my thanks.
Sure. Don't worry about it.
Even in the midst of combat, you really do look out for others. But taking your focus off your opponents like that could land you in an early grave.
I guess it could.
Of course, I wouldn't want to fight with someone who didn't give a damn about me either. So keep up the good work, champ.
Will do.
So in other words, you only want to fight with people who are willing to die young.
No, you got it all wrong. I only want to fight with people who are willing to help me die old.
You've come.
So in the end, you've chosen to trust that man. You're more naive than I thought, Maxwell.
Tell us what your purpose is for bringing us here.
We will stand and fight against those invaders. If you intend to challenge them yourselves, we won't attempt to stop you.
But first, there's something you need to tell us. I want you to tell us what you know about the schism.
What's that?
Two millennia ago, I cast the spirit art, Schism. It created a new world and sealed it away. That world is yours. It is known as Risa Maxia.
Did Mila just say that she created the entire world?
Wow! She's like a goddess or something!
It was for protecting spirits and humans.
Risa Maxia is sealed. That implies the existence of another world outside the Schism, does it not?
Yes. And that world is called Olympias. I was gravely mistaken about the Lance of Kresnik's true purpose. Exodus convinced Noctigal that it was a weapon, but all along they were plotting to create a device that would dispel the Schism.
Dispel the Schism? To what end?
I do not know. I wonder if perhaps they were looking for a means to siphon mana back to Olympias.
No. All Exodus ever wanted was to go home. Back home to Olympias. It's all we've wanted for more than 20 years since we became trapped in Risa Maxia. We needed to find a way to either break through the Schism or dispel it completely.
But in order to dispel the Schism, they would have to find a way to eliminate its creator.
I see. So that's why Exodus kept trying to kill you.
It doesn't add up. What is Gillen's master plan?
I'm confused. I still don't understand.
Gillen's actions are not going to get Exodus home any faster.
He didn't need to bring the whole Olympian army. In unifying Risa Maxia, that was never our original intention.
Gillen must intend to make use of Risa Maxia with the Schism intact, but for what purpose?
That's it. The Otherworld Reactor Plan.
What?
Huh? The hell's that?
Most folks knew it as the Spirit Fuel Plan.
That sounds bad.
I remember my cousin telling me about it, when I was still a kid back on the other side. Something about capturing spirits and using them as fuel for Spyrexes.
So you're saying Gillen's ultimate goal is to corral all the spirits?
But that doesn't make sense either. If all he wants is spirits, then why bother with the lies? Unless he's planning on trapping us in Risa Maxia for our mana lobes.
He seeks to use the people of Risa Maxia as a power source? The man is insane.
Gillen most likely returned to Exodus HQ on the ocean. The Olympian army is with him, so getting there by boat won't be easy.
Well then, perhaps we can commandeer one of the flying ships they have, docked at Kambalar.
Oh yeah, right. Because that sounds easy.
It may indeed be our only option.
Very well. We attack tomorrow.
Wait a minute, Gaius! Aren't we gonna team up on this? I mean, we both want the same thing, so...
It's not a social gathering.
Just how stupid are you anyway?
It was Maxwell who created the schism and trapped us all inside of it in the first place. Imprisonment is not so easily forgiven. It's entirely possible we may end up fighting each other again.
I'm sure you can understand why we're not ready to get all buddy-buddy with you.
Like I said, do what you want. Just make sure to stay out of our way.
Can you believe it? The nerve of those guys!
They must be short-handed. Why else would they share that kind of information with us?
Despite what they said, I still believe that they are counting on all of us.
For now, at least.
Perhaps this is the opportunity to speak to Wingle that I've been waiting for.